goodness.
Yeah, and we're not dealing with any sort of inches of snow or inches of anything, really.
We could get some inches of rain, perhaps?
Yeah, no, not even that.
Not even an inch of rain.
We got nothing in the inch department, guys. Some spotty showers are going to be possible today. In fact, we'll take you over to our Viper Plus radar and show you where a little bit of light rain is falling right now. We're watching just this little band of showers coming in here from off the Atlantic into southern Brevard County, southern Osceola County, down there toward Kenansville, and maybe in toward Palm Bay later on. A little less quick sprinkle going by, not much. So we're just going to keep an eye on our slight chance of rain today, mainly over at the coast this morning, but then over toward the afternoon hours in the inland locations as well. We'll take a look at the bigger picture. Satellite radar picture is revealing mainly a partly cloudy sky across central Florida. When the sun comes up, we'll get a better look at it. But you can see there on the radar picture, the larger view, the only band of showers I'm tracking is right there coming in towards southern Brevard. So that's it for now. 56 degrees at Orlando International Airport, a seasonably cool start. 52 back at the Villages. It's 63 over at the Space Center. We continue to see upper 60s at Melbourne this morning with that wind off the ocean about 10 miles an hour here. But a lot less wind today. You can see here the numbers 3, 6, 5. That's a lot better than the 15, 20 that we were dealing with yesterday at this time. So a lot less wind today, just a slight chance of rain. High temperatures will continue to recover into the mid-70s as we head up to Orlando, 76. Daytona Beach at 74. Melbourne, you'll be about 77. And back around Ocala, a high of 73 degrees this Tuesday afternoon. Sunrise at 7:17, and our normal high is 72. So we are going back above average starting today and I think into tomorrow, too. Now, we do have a small craft advisory that will continue today. It's mainly for the seas. The winds are coming down, but we still have that 5 to 7 foot sea out there, and the low tide there about 2 o'clock this afternoon. Rip currents will continue to be an issue, especially into the late morning and early afternoon hours. Satellite and radar picture, again, across the southeast U.S., things are looking fairly quiet across central Florida, but it's this next batch of some moisture that I'm watching here. There's just an area of low pressure that's trying to spin in here in that fast west to east flow, and what that might do is help to generate a spotty shower for us today. Not much, but again, we do have that chance to see a bit of rain today. Then our next focus is up here. This cold front moving on in sometime on Wednesday night or Thursday, and that's going to bring us to cooler weather. But until then, a little fog overnight tonight and some warm weather coming up tomorrow. And I think tomorrow is a dry day as that moisture is expected to decrease once again. There's your 7-day forecast. Upper 60s to even mid-60s as we round out the work week. I put a slight chance of rain in Thursday as the front rolls through, but not a whole lot of moisture to work with, so it's not going to be too impressive. Not talking about inches of rain or anything like that. Next weekend, looking great. Mid to upper 70s, Scott. Back
Take
into
that.
The summertime forecast. There you go.